Welcome to this video on integrating Azure Key Vault or AKV with Azure Kubernetes Service, AKS. There are different ways in which Kubernetes allows us to handle secrets or configuration files. We can mount secrets as a base64 encoded data and store them as Kubernetes objects. We can also store them in configuration maps or config maps and mount them as volumes inside the Kubernetes pods. We can also store the secret or configuration related data into external providers like HashiCorp Vault and integrate that with Kubernetes. And we can also use some projects like sealed secrets, which allow us to seal the secrets and encrypt them instead of just storing them in the base64 encoded format. In this video, we are going to look at how to use the Azure Key Vault, which is an enterprise grade vault, which allows us to store secrets external to Kubernetes cluster and integrate that with the Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS. Let's get started. Let's see what are the prerequisites for using this kind of setup or running this kind of setup. First and foremost, we need a AKS cluster or Azure Kubernetes Service cluster. And we need to enable the Azure Key Vault provider for secret store CSI driver. This driver allows the secrets or configurations to be stored external and then mount them as a volume. And once the pod is attached with the volume, that data is available to the pods to use as secrets or configuration maps. We also need Azure CLI or AZ CLI 2.30 or 2.30 version or later, and we need Azure Key Vault or AKV. So let's get started and see what do we need to do to make this happen. First and foremost, as I said, we need the Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS cluster. In the interest of time, I have already created this cluster and we use the Azure CLI for this. I've run this command az AKS create and then provided some parameters in terms of creating the cluster. The most important thing here is the second last parameter here, which says that enable add-on Azure Key Vault Secret Provider. Add-ons are a way of extending the capabilities of Azure Kubernetes Service cluster. And this is one of the add-on which is provided by default or out of the box with Azure Kubernetes Service. Once this is available or once this is installed, when the cluster is created, we will already have the resources which are required or resources which are deployed as part of this secret store CSI driver and secret stores provider for Azure. So if we run this command to get the pods in the kube system namespace using the selector, we see that there are three replicas or there are three instances of the AKS secret store CSI driver running, and there are also three replicas of the AKS secret store provider Azure running. That is the first step where we have this up and running. Next, we need a secret or we need to create a secret and store it inside. But before we store the secret, we need the key vault. This again can be created using a CLI command, az Key Vault create, and we can pass parameters like the name, the resource group, and the location. And we need to enable the role-based access control authorization for this. In the interest of time, again, I've gone ahead and created this. And we have this, the cluster as well as the Key Vault created. So this is the Key Vault named as demo AKVNG, which we are going to use for this demo. When we create the Kubernetes cluster, we can also verify looking at the cluster configuration whether the secret store CSI driver is enabled or not. When we see this checkbox ticked, that means the CSI store driver has been enabled or the add-on has been applied to this cluster at the time of creation of the Kubernetes cluster. Next, we need to store this secret into the Kubernetes cluster. So in one of the earlier videos, I was using the Azure API key for the OpenAI key. So I'm going to store that Azure AI or OpenAI API key as a secret in the AKV. I can use this command store that or to create that particular secret inside the AKV or Azure Key Vault. We use the Key Vault secret create command or set command. We specify the vault name as demo AKVNG. And the name of the key or the secret is Azure Open API key or AI API key. And the value is whatever is the value stored in my environment variable. I've already created this environment variable beforehand, and the value of that environment variable gets assigned to this particular key in the AKV. Now, if we go back to the Azure portal and we look at the keys section here in the AKV section, we have keys, secrets, and certificates. So here under the secrets, we can find this Azure OpenAI API key created. The next step for this is to give permissions to the resource group which is created, or the permission for the object or identity which will use this particular secret. So we need to integrate, or we need to give permission to the Azure Key Vault to read the key from the Azure Kubernetes cluster or AKS cluster. When we run the Kubernetes cluster, or when we create the Kubernetes cluster, there is one identity which is created. So if we go back to the way we created the cluster, we will see that I've also enabled this enable manage identity. And as part of this, and as part of the Azure Key Vault Secret Provider add-on, a managed identity will be automatically created and assigned to the Kubernetes cluster. We can use this managed identity to provide the required access to the Azure Key Vault. So let's first see what are the different identities associated with this Kubernetes cluster. So if I run the az aks show command and give the name of the Kubernetes cluster, in the output, it will show all the properties of that particular Kubernetes cluster. We are interested in this particular add-on profile, which says that the Azure Key Vault Secret Provider is a profile which is created, and this has an identity associated with that, with a client ID and object ID. We would be needing this client ID a little later, but this is how we can find out what is the identity that is associated with the Azure Key Vault Secret Provider. Now, this secret provider needs to have access to the key that we created in Azure Key Vault. For that, we need to give the required permission so that the identity can pull the secret or can access the secret from Azure Key Vault. This is done by using the command or by assigning the role to that particular identity. Let's run some of these commands and get these identity into the environment variable or shell variables, and then we will assign the role which is required. First thing we do is to get the identity object ID, or the ID of that particular identity. This is under a special resource group which is created, and then we also have the name. So using this query parameter, we fetch the client ID and store it inside the identity object ID shell variable. Then we go and fetch the scope, or we define the scope for which this particular operation would be applicable. So this is applicable only for the key vault, which is named as demo AKVNG. We don't want to give this permission to the whole resource group or to all the resources in our subscription. This is very, very specific to the key vault itself. And then we go and assign the role, or we create a role by running this az role command. We run the assignment. The role that we are giving is Key Vault Administrator. We assign the identity of the Azure Key Vault Provider Secret Store identity. Then the scope is defined at the Key Vault level. With that, we have given the permission as the administrator. We can do this also using the GUI based approach, or if you prefer the user interface under the AKV or Key Vault. If we go to the access control, we can see the different role assignments which are currently assigned or applicable for this particular instance of the Azure Key Vault. In here, we can add a new role assignment, and we can search for different roles. These are the different roles which are supported or built in. If we just filter this by Key Vault, we can see the Key Vault Administrator, Key Vault Certificate User, and various other roles here. Let's say we want to assign the Key Vault Administrator role. We can say next year, and then we can select the member. So this exact step is what we did via the CLI. If I say Azure Key, we can see the identity here, and then we can select that particular identity, and same way we can assign this particular role. Since we have already assigned that role via the CLI, I'm not going to do it using the UI, but either way, you can do it using the graphical user interface, or you can do it using the CLI. One way or the other, we need to give this permission to the identity so that it can access the keys in the key vault. Next thing is we need to create a secret store provider class or a resource. This is done using a manifest file in Kubernetes. So here I have a YAML file definition. We create a kind of object which is named as secret provider class, and we specify the links between our key vault and the identity, along with the other specifications like provider as Azure, the parameters as using the pod identity as false, use VM managed identity as true, because this is what we are using as part of the managed identity process. We specify what is the user assigned identity ID, and this is where we use that client ID. So if we go back and again we run the command for AZAKS and we run the show command, and when we scroll back to the Azure Key Vault Secret Provider, this is the client ID that I'm talking about. We need to select this and we need to put in here E75 whatever is the big ID. The next thing we need is the key vault name. This is the demo AKV key vault NG or demo AKV NG, the name of our Azure key vault. And finally, we need the tenant ID. This we can get by looking at the key vault details. So if we go back to the key vaults and the overview, the directory ID is what is the tenant ID. We need to copy that here. Once this is done, we can apply this to our Kubernetes cluster and we will have an object of the type as secret provider class. So this is the link between our Kubernetes cluster and the Azure Key Vault or AKV. This is how Kubernetes will interact with the Azure Key Vault. Now there needs to be something which will use that particular secret. For that, I have created a test pod which is using the BusyBox image. And inside the busy box, we are going to mount this as a volume. So we start with the volumes definition. We give a name for this as secret store 01 inline volume. Then we specify the metadata in terms of the CSI driver. The driver here is secret store CSI. And the volume attributes that we specify is the Azure Key Vault user MSI. This needs to match with the secret store provider metadata name that we created for the secret store provider class or secrets provider class. This is the same name that we gave here in the metadata that we specify as an attribute for the secret provider class. And then we mount it as a volume, and that gets mounted onto the path as /mnt or /mount and secret store. So let's go and apply both of these manifest files to our Kubernetes cluster. Inside our KTS folder, I've got these different manifest files which are required for running my application. And under the AKV integration, we have the secret provider class and the testpod.yaml file. Both these can be applied together using kapply or kubectl apply. And we can give -r -f. And then we can specify the AKV integration as the folder. This will apply the secret provider class and it will create the BusyBox image which uses the secret inside that particular class. So we can verify this by going into lens and looking at the pods. We have the BusyBox pod which is created just about 20 seconds ago. This under the mounts, which says that mount secret store is mounted. We can also go into this shell, or we can get into the pod using the shell, and then we can run the command here to say mount secret store, and we can see that Azure OpenAPI API key, which was the name of our key in the Azure Key Vault, is now mounted as a file here. We can also see the contents of that by running this command cat mnt secret store and then the Azure OpenAPI API key. This is the content of that particular API key. So with that, we can confirm that the Kubernetes cluster is able to pull the key vault related secret into the pod and mount it as a file using the volumes approach. So that was a quick demo of how to integrate Azure Key Vault or AKV with the Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS cluster. In summary, what we did here was it looks quite easy, but then it is quite a complex process. We have the Azure Kubernetes cluster and the Azure Key Vault in the same resource group created here. And then we have a managed identity, user assigned managed identity, which is assigned to the Azure Key Vault Secret Provider. We give the permission for that identity to the Azure Key Vault. And then inside the Key Vault, we have this Azure OpenAI API key. When we create a Secret Provider class, we link the Kubernetes related identity or Azure related user assigned managed identity to the Azure Key Vault. And then we also specify what is the secret that we want to pull as part of this particular secret provider class. This gets mounted as a volume, and then when the pod is created, that volume is mounted inside the pod, and that is how the pod is able to access the secret which is stored inside Azure Key Vault. Don't go anywhere else. We still have a lot of content on this channel where I've demonstrated how to use things like Prometheus, RabbitMQ, Keda, Dapper. Have a look at those videos and I'm sure you will find them useful. Thanks for watching this. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.